I propose you to show you and to share these two different presentations, which are almost the same, about the use of some big data in order to have some grasp of the strategical visitor flow. Let me tell you a little bit the story of our institute, which is the Institute of Tourism, the Applied University of Western Switzerland. This is a paper that we presented. Well, what is interesting in our sector, in tourism, is to have an idea of frequentation. What it would be best is to have an idea of the economical impact, but this is another story. It's more difficult to have. But still, have a good picture about frequentation is a very important matter. Nevertheless, at least in Switzerland, this statistic was not successful. In the beginning, it was not successful because of the timeliness, but now it's not successful about the exhaustivity, because some elements are out of the statistic, which is all the self-catering part. Then I am going to talk about the traditional way, how in 2004 we figured out a model in order to spell out the total frequentation. Then I will talk about the new data indicators using mobile phones on one hand and a guest car whose name is Be My Guest, which is be used in Freiburg, and we make some first analysis, and then, well, some conclusion and future research. Then one of the objectives of our institute, we are based in Valle. Valle is the canton where you have the Matterhorn, the Cervan. Zermatt is in Valle, Verbier, the very well-known ski resort, expensive ski resort are in Valle. We have the big five, which is Gramontana, Leukebad, Zermatt, Verbier, and I like one, but... it's not part of the five, but it's very important also. I would come to my mind.
But
we don't have cheap. We have a good deal between the money you pay and the value you have. No, we have the pallet, but these big five are quite important, and they are driven the Zermatt is driven, the quarter of the overnight come from Zermatt in the international tourism. Well, then we tried to develop indirect indicators in order to provide some information about tourism variable. And then this is the first research. What is an indirect indicator for us? Well, an indirect indicator is a variable, a data, that it is connected with not having as a vocation to give some information about tourism. But they are collecting in the regular basis, and we can get the value more quickly than the frequentation of tourists, namely the overnights. And these variables are the domestic waste tonnage that is collected in months in each destination but towns. And then the cash register recipe of food, of food per choice, which is per choice, general per choice, with the two biggest supermarket in Switzerland, that they are Coop and Migros in Valle. It means that every first day of the month, we have the number of cash register tickets that they get the month before in every point of the supermarket in Valle. Well, why this is relevant for tourism? Well, because Switzerland, one of the reasons is that Switzerland is highly Souvenirs of chocolates are highly important, and people go to supermarket to buy chocolate. People don't go to souvenir shops, they go to supermarket. First of all, because it's cheaper. Second is because it's fresh. And the other data that it's very, very timeliness is the number of vehicles on the road. Then what are the direct indicators that we have? Well, the direct indicator are the overnight by hotel, guest house, that they are collected by the Swiss Federal Statistics Office on monthly basis. And it means that hoteliers have to give the number of overnight per country with the origin of the country because it is compulsory by law. There is the law of statistics that they have to do that. But there is a big amount of overnight that we don't know, or we hardly know, or we know in a very partial way, which is in terms of regionality, which is self-catering, guest night. That it means people that go to rental apartment and house. We have some data from the Office de Turismo. The close data that we have about self-catering is the tax day, you know. I think that all around the world, the most spread practice is that tourists has to pay a tax every day, which is the tax. Then we know in the end of the year how much money they collected because this day tourist tax. And then we have an idea per year, but which is the amount of money, not the amount, the number of overnights, and we don't have the decomposition per month. Okay? Well, given that, we try to spread down the data per month. Of course, I will not explain all the econometric model, but if you like, I can show you the paper, which is the one version is written in English and also in French. It's published in a Canadian publication. What is interesting is how I will give the broad idea how we deal with this. Well, the first thing to do was we have an idea of self-catering, but for self-catering, the only thing that we know is the amount of money they collected annually. Then we have two problems: converted that into overnight. Second, make the distribution of this amount of overnight over the year. Then, in order to convert the money to overnight, it's easy, because you know how much they pay, then you just divide it and you have the number of overnight. This is easy. But to spread this amount of overnights, which is given annually per month, this is another thing. And what we use is a method that was a method of benchmarking that was theoretically was developed by Professor Dagun, who was an Argentinian professor who goes first to Bologna and then to Canada. And we use a program that was developed by Statistics Canada. And let me show you which is the result. Here you can see in this graph, this is self-catering. And the point that you see here, the pink point is the distribution of the overnight per year, per month during that year, that follow the distribution of the ticket of the supermarket whose name is Coppi. And then we use the other one, which is the data from Migros. And you can see the two series using the same data but from different brands, they are really close. Here you have the mean. We divided the number of overnight that we get annually per 12. And this is what is showing you is the distribution over the 12 years. And this distribution is made following the number of tickets of supermarket. And you see, given that there are two different supermarkets, the distribution is similar. Then if se non è vero, è bien trovato. The second thing that we have done is the same, but instead of using self-catering, people who rent the apartment are people who are owner of apartment. The owner of apartment pay if they stay less than 42 days. If they stay less than 42 days, what they do is they pay an amount of money. And they can be if they stay more than 42 years a day, they pay an amount of money and they can stay more. If they stay less, it is better to pay per day. Then, once more, the DMO has the amount of money they have by people that they are owner of resident of a secondary house. Then we apply the same method, and you see once more the two series, when you break down following the seasonality of the ticket of supermarket, are very similar. I have to say that we do that first with one destination, which is Sobrana, who has exactly per month very, very reliable data. Exactly is not the word to use in statistics. Very reliable data per month. And following that, we realized that the way we are using to break down the annual number of overnights per month using the supermarket data were good. Then we have the data of hotels. We have an idea of the data of self-catering. On one hand, people that rent the apartment. On the other hand, the people that have secondary homes and go to the destination. Then we apply using the number of waste, the number of, of trash during the destination. We use an econometric method using time series. And finally, we can really split up the overnights in this way. Here, this is for Verbier. We do that for Verbier, who is a destination who has very low level of hotels. The biggest part, the biggest share of overnight is self-catering. This one is given by Office Federal de la Statistique. This one are, one is the people going in their old secondary house, and the other, which are the triangle, which are the square, are the people that they are renting apartment. And the dot here, over there, are either day trippers, either people that stay there, but don't pay the tax. It means people supernumerary, if you like. The people that go there and don't pay the tax. Well, in the end of the story, what we have taken here, in order to calculate this, we have taken the number of cars per month. And really, it follows the number of cars. Why this is stopping here? Because here, even in Switzerland, the system to count cars break down. And they don't... They forget to repair. That's why the model finish here. Why we do that? Because in this way, we can have an idea, first of all, of the total frequentation, not only hotels, but having an idea of self-catering, day trippers, and secondary resident. And given that, we can forecast. The problem with the data for hotels, that the only hard data that for the moment we have, is that they came only 40 days after the month finish. It means that you have to wait a month and a half in order to have the frequentation of the data. And if you want to have a prospective way, a proactive way to face a crisis, you cannot, because you are not even sure that you have a crisis. You have an idea, of course, that things are not going as you like, but you don't know how much. And you don't know it is worthwhile to make an investment of 1 million in communication, television, and so forth, in order to save the season. In this way, we think that we can make a better analysis. Well, but you see, yes? No, I don't calculate the number of cars. They are counting.
How do you count it?
There are two methods. Either is a method that there is a like the kind of line, and they count how many cross the line, and then there is another who measure the length of the car. Then you can know if it is a van, which kind of van. If he has a van with a bag and afterwards, and if it is a car, there are also motorcycles that can be counting. No, no, for the when the counting is working is every month. Yes, it's real time. Okay. It's real time.
So you can have an idea that this
winter they have more traffic and this. Oh yes. Yes, it's real time. I have not, but it's real time data. You can have per day. What is the limit of indirect indicator? Well, the time in, yes.
Maybe I missed something, but you will.
Yes,
go on.
Okay. Yes, because we use the data of the DMOs, of the Destination Management Organization, and they are different account. They cash different. The tax that is paid by the people who rent apartment, and the tax of the people that have a secondary home.
So people that have a secondary home also pay?
Yes. You have to pay a tax. If I live in Lausanne, I go to stay one night in Sierra, I have to pay the tax.
But if you stay in hotel, you pay tax, right?
Yes.
If you stay in a private home or something?
Normally, a good citizen go and say, I have my cousin at home, how much I have to pay? You should do that. No, you have, yes, a moral advantage that you are doing thinking. That's why we use waste, the tonnage. And the tonnage is showing you here, which is either they are day trippers, either they are people that were there and don't pay the tax. And in order to know how many are day trippers, we use the count of the cars. I can send you the paper. It's just several levels of economics models that overlap. Yes?
The waste that you're using is the waste of the restaurants or the general waste?
It's the whole waste, which is are not big ones, you know? Because in Switzerland, as you probably figure out, everything is classified. Then they are, I don't know which is the technical name, but it's the domestic. We don't take if people throw out furniture or computers, you see?
No.
It's the regular one.
So from the whole region, not just restaurants, the population of one area?
Yes. And it's a very good indicator because we have made some analysis, because it's not working in every destination. But we have a ratio,
you cannot compare between destinations then?
It means, no, it's that the model don't work in either destination because it depends of the kind of data that you have. For the first time, it depends of the kind of data that you have of the trash. Because as you see, these variables are not collected because of tourism reasons. They are just collected because other administrative reason. Then people, for instance, they could not be so, how could they say, so aware of the value of making the best adjustment as it was. But then this is one problem. The other problem is that sometimes even the data that the hotels declare are not very accurate. This could happen. And then also a lot of people go there and don't declare and don't pay tax. Then it depends on destination. But we do in 5-6 destination and we get a ratio, which is the number of kilos per inhabitant and the number of kilos per tourist. You see, you have this ratio. And this is a kind of cuentas del almacenero. You know, grocery accounting, finally.
Anyway, it's not the same the waste is doing somebody in Switzerland that the waste is doing somebody in another place of the world.
No, it's even worse. It's even worse. From one municipality to the another, you have difference.
Yeah, because the culture of recycling or the culture of throwing things is different from one place to another, so... You can compare from the same place, no? But not from very different places.
No, yes, you're right. The model is applied only by destination. And we made different model. We applied by destination. I made some analysis only by municipalities, you see? But they are different point, different spot, and we made the sum up of the spot, of different spot of collecting, you see? We tried to use electricity consumption. We try to use also the how we call the concentration of carbon in wastewaters, but this was a problem because if this rain, the concentration is drop because it's just raining. Then we really take a big number of indirect indicators, and the best were this one. It was a big work. But of course, the time is somehow not as good as we like, because what we are looking forward is having pseudo real time frequentation data. Is it possible? It would be nice to have every day and compare the equivalent day of this year with the equivalent days of the year before, or having the frequentation every week. Every destination knows how was this week in compared from the week of the year before. And with this data, we cannot face fast to that still. Then we go to one idea that overlap this other, which is the study of the strategic visitor flows. You know, in the beginning, if you read the paper of the 80s, sure, some of you, or if it is not, you can read, we tried to analyze the trajectory of visitors. And at that time, people, when we were kids, our parents go to a place, stay there, and come back. Probably they go around, but if you go there, you stay 2 or 3 months and you come back, because the cost of travel was so expensive that you cannot go around or going for 1 week. Going to one week, it was not really a good value if you put in the basket the travel issue. Then at that moment, we thought about a very statistical way to analyze trajectories of tourists. It was just go and stay. But given that the transportation is going down with all this low cost and so forth, people stay less time, people are more mobile, and it is interesting to know how they move. And I will explain why in the next talk. But Sangal, our friends from Sangal, they say that there are at least these different patterns. You see, here you have all the demand, and the demand could be clustered, but could be clustered following the trajectory they use. And they say, well, they are prototype, different prototype. This is Sangal who says, but you can find also in the 90s, in the 80s. They say, well, one is you go, you put, you stay and put. It means as when we were kids, our parents go there, Benidorm, and in my case was Mar del Plata, 3 months, we stay there, and then we come back. Then you go there to go somewhere else. Then you go there, and then you go around all the time. Like, for instance, yes, go there, and you go around. Then you can make an arranged touring. You know that you go, and you go around, and you come back to the same point. And then there is a hub and a spoke. For instance, instead of go to Venice, you go to Bergamo. You stay in Bergamo, and you go to Venice, and you go around, but you stay in Bergamo because you can afford the hotel. Think that probably in Venice, at least it is your honeymoon. It's really, really very... Then they say, well, this is the trajectories. Let's try to find the clusters. Because if we have the plaster, then we can make better marketing. Which are the tools that we have to do that? Then how could we have this idea how people go? Because in the very lower level, what you need is really the information in the individual level. How could you get the information on the individual level? Then... what we need is to have enough data to be able to make an aggregation try to cluster these trajectories. That it couldn't, they are not mutually exclusive. Probably a person in one moment go and stay, and probably in another experience, in another travel, he decided to take a bus and make a tour. On another, he make free will. He say, we go there, and then we see if it is good. We go to the mountain. If the weather is good, we go to the mountain. If not, we go to the city nearby, and we go to the museum because it's raining and so far. And this will, I will come back later if I remember. I hope that will not. Then, well, where can I find relevant data to do that? Well, here we studied two possible options. We are working still of that. One is to use this loyalty or discard card. We use one of Freiburg, whose name is Be My Guest. And the other is to use mobile phones. We make our research parallel with the European project. We didn't know that there was an European project when we were running our project, but we make it parallel. Then I will talk of the European project because it's similar to us. Then you can go, and it's very interesting. It's free. You can go to download this European reports. They are very, very well done and fully described. And this is the data that they use in the European. They have a set of data like this. This is the data of the mobile phone. You have a subscriber. You have you have identification. You have a time, and you know in which cells, in which antenna they have, and you know where they come from. This should be a French phone that at that time was captured with this antenna. This is the data that use European project. And this is how they do. And so do us. The best the best geolocalization that you have using this kind of data is the antenna. You know, here you have an antenna. But the problem is the accuracy of the antenna. The antenna don't mean that the people were just here, because if you are in an area and this antenna is really crowded, probably your phone will pick it up by another antenna who is far away. It's farther than the one that it was close, because the coverage is changed depending on the number of phones that they are, the mobiles that they are connected. The more the mobiles are connected to the antenna, the less bigger is the cover of the surface. Then it's an approximation, but it's not a very wrong approximation for the time being, you see? Then here, probably, you are here, this should be the antenna that has to cut, that have to cut, but you are captured by this antenna, you see? And all the people that they are around, they will be geolocalized in this. But sometimes this area have 23 kilometers. It depends, but sometimes it could be very huge. But this is the level of error. Well, what do you think that we have if we can exploit this kind of data? Well, the thing that is, you have a good consistency, even though that the precision of the geolocalization is not very accurate. You have a good consistency because you captured finally all the phones that they are there. Well, it depends of the cover of the operator that where the data I produce. But at least you know, if you have an operator which is 60% of the market, you know that you have 60% of the people. Then you have less, you know the bias, I mean, which you don't know with using another method. Then you have superior coverage. You have the breakdown by region and nationality. Sometimes you don't have that with normal data. In the things that I show you, the self-catering, I don't know where they come from. I don't know the country where they come from. Me one with mobile data you have, you have to improve the timeliness, because we make some proof and we think that we could be able to give a good analysis of frequentation every Saturday for the week before. Then it is pseudo-real data analysis. It is possible to make an automatization of the statistical production. It's possible to have possible cost effect, because if you make with a survey, it could be impossible to have this coverage. And of course, it's very, very, very lower the cost. If I have to say, I have a dream, like the others say. Well, my dream is that Europe arrived with an agreement with the phone operators. And phone operators give this data, they produce themselves, they get the aggregator of data, in order that we compare fully frequentation on each country in the regular basis and using the same method. You see what I mean? The same method of counting. And that would be great, and I probably will already retire, but I'm looking forward that economic union go there, because we can spare a lot of money. But of course, country could not lie and say, now we have more, because every country, no, I don't say that every country, but it could be possible that some countries touch a little bit the statistics, you see? This would be the same method. Well, which is the dark part of the line? Well, you don't have information about which is the purpose, which they come for business, if they come for leisure, for the time being. There is some bias in the certification between a day tripper and overnight. If you raise the question, I can show you how we figure out. But there are very specific way to do that. There are a lady who is come from Venezuela, I think. She's working in MIT. His name is Marta Gonzalez. she's making a very nice work trying to figure out how to spill out the reason of movement of people using mobile data. I will show you, I will give you some ideas. Well, there is a possible misclassification of actual Tourism 7 because probably there is an event and you didn't know that the event was there, and then there is and you don't know why you have this amount of people over there. There are over and undercover issues, probably given that for people coming from Latin America and even from Swiss, because we pay a lot of roaming, we turn off the phone during the night. Then if somebody turn off the phone, you lose him. Then it's like if it was not in the statistic, you lose some people. It's difficult to know how people use phones during travel, but next year there will not. Do you have a roaming charge? Europeans have roaming charge, but I think next year it will be Greece. It could be the same. You could speak to Switzerland, even if we are not in the European Union, and you can speak to France. It would be the same that if you speak in Spain. This is a good news, and you don't have any socio-demographic breakdown. You don't know if the people is a man, is a woman. Thank God, because protection of data. Well, then what I have is the opportunity and benefit. We have better completeness that traditional sources. You can have that pseudo real time. The validity, I don't think it could be said that it's better or worse than traditional method. What I really can say that is less cost when the mobile phones put the system in movement. Accuracy, you see you have a big data. The problem is what is a usual environment? Because if you remember, the definition of tourist by the WTO is someone who goes away from their usual environment. What is the usual environment? This is really a lack of definition. And the resolution. The resolution is very important because you can be very, very fine. You can have a very fine granulation. You can say, I am interested or the people that they are in this town. Then you just choose the coordinate of the antenna that they are near. We were lucky enough to make this project in Switzerland, which is parallel with the one of European, with there was monitor, and we tried to build up this kind of thing. We work with the national provider of phone mobile phone, and we have aggregated data. Then we have the opportunity to process our own programs. On the data that were real data, and then we give the program to the company who run the process and let us to know the aggregation of data. Then we never have individual data. Is that clear? Okay, this is very important. This is the kind of things that we have, and we were very happy. How can I turn on this thing? Hello, it's working. The operator, sir. Hello, it's working. Ah, okay.
Working?
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. Then, you see, what we have done is, using this data, we use some study which was a festival, original festival in Freiburg, whose name is Benichon. And this is the kind of data. Here I have the number of hotels that, the number, excuse me,
the number of phone coming from French. Yes.
Is off the micro.
Allo, allo. Thank you. Yes, this we have from the date we decided here. There was 3 days that we study, and we have how many. This is the number of phones that were captured by the antenna that we show, and this is the maximal state that we have. And then here we have the duration mean. How, yes, the time that the French stayed in the region, the mean of the time, and then in Germany and so far. Then you see you have a lot of information that is very accurate and very descriptive. It's okay what I am saying? May I go on? Then, as I tell you, this was about have a statics statistic, which is the same that we have now using this kind of survey. Now, what we were interested in is the dynamic, how people were traveling during these 3 days in the Benichon. You see here, we studied two events. We studied the Benichon, and we studied the Omega Open Master in Valle, in Cramontana, which is a very well-known contest in golf. Then I will show you some films that we had made. Then the aggregation of data I show you. I have another aggregation data to show. Now I have some films, which make a kind of Disneyland. I hope that it will work. Yes. Here is the. Please, I'm sorry. It is so little. Here is the time. These are the districts in Freiburg. And this number changed because every half an hour they are telling you how many Swiss tourists are there every half an hour per district during 3 days. And we do that using programming the data of phones, you see. This is the 19th of September. This is night. This is 9 o'clock, 9:30, 10 o'clock. This is by night. You see, people are going back home, and every district you have how many people were, how many phones that we think that belongs to tourists that they are no local were there. The question that you don't ask me, but I think that you should ask me is, how do you know which were tourists and which were locals? Well, we have the same idea that our colleagues of the European project. We say, which is the mean average of a stay in Freiburg? 2 days. Okay. Then we ask to the company, we write a program saying, you take 2 weeks. Day trippers, you see. Yes,
we check during the day.
It is it's more than Swiss. What we have done is write a program and ask our company, Swiss Com. We take 2 weeks before and 2 weeks after. And we ask the company, we don't ask, we write the program that they process. Then we have aggregated data that all the people that were 2 weeks before and stay by night, and people that were there and stay by night were out of the sample. This is a quick and dirty way to do that. Another way that we have not developed yet, that we are very keen to do, is the way that this lady, this wonderful lady of MIT, Marta González, made. If you think about, it's not working. Mm-hmm. that the another way, if you think of your life, sometimes it's useful. Here you have time, okay? This is time. And this is where you live. How is your life? You, I say, 8 o'clock, you go out, you go there, you go to the university. Probably then, from there, you go there, because you go to fitness, I don't know, or you go to supermarket, and then you come back, and this is T1. And then T2, okay, you see the same thing. You go there, you go to the another thing, probably you go to see your father, come back. And then you study, and you have this kind of this kind of pattern. And when somebody do like this, this is horrible. And she developed algorithms that take into account this. And we will be more than happy to develop them. This is we work with 2 and 3 G, but 4 G, yes, is the only thing we get, and we are very
happy. How do you do it? Drivers, for example.
A bigger one?
With
the last development I made the difference. Well, okay, this is a la luz. as I said, roughly speaking. And let me show you, this was frequentation, you see? But frequentation, instead that every month we are willing to make frequentation every half an hour, which is no bad. Because for once in our time we could have an idea of the seasonality per hour a day, which is just a thing that is not possible to have. And let me show you now the Benichon. The Benichon, this is for Swiss people. How the people, the Benichon is in bull. The Benichon is in bull, which is here. This is a heat map. Every circle has more than 10 phones. It means that they have at least 10 phones. And this is how people, this is, you know, every hour, 9 o'clock, midnight, 4 o'clock in the morning, every hour you see how people, Swiss, are going there. This is for Swiss. I can show you slower because we made two. This is for Swiss. And then we make for instance, here are Germans, you see? And here you have every hour. This is by night, this is midnight, no, this is 5 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the evening, this is midnight, and this is how people are going during the 3 days of the Benichon, what was here, and how they come. See, well, this is very simplified way. Everyone who was German was supposed to be a tourist. That's it. And another, we make also French. Because you cannot do everything. If you have less than a number of data, the company will not yield you the data. What was interesting here is during, because it is Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, what we have observed is that French, during the evening of Sunday, then don't take the high road, but they take the cantonal one. Probably due to the alcohol controls, or that they don't have the vignette. But we thought that there was the director of the...
And each road is one
phone? Each road is at least 10 phones.
10 phones.
Yes, because if not, it's this. Probably 15, probably 15, because... Swiss are this is everybody together. Swiss, French, Germans. This is how they weigh. And here, I'm sorry, this is the company. I'm sorry that we have here not visualization. This is 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the afternoon. This is midnight. Well, this is another story. You are working on there. I would be very happy to discuss it with you. Then this is another story. You see things dynamic. Well, and the first one I show you, I don't know if I show you, this is the, no, I haven't not shown you. This is the, here is Cramontana, where the master, this is Cramontana, where the master take out, and this is the Swiss people. This is 9 o'clock in the morning, okay. If you like to, I can put it once more. Yes. This is 6 o'clock in the morning, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 2 in the morning. You see how people came to this master goal. Well, this is what we have done so far. And now, this is, you see, this is aggregation. This is how people really move. But we have not still patterns, trajectory patterns, that we don't have yet. We have an aggregate level, but we don't have aggregated level of patterns. And in order to do that, the thing that we use, from the mathematical point of view is the theory of networks, where you have a global matrix of density, the average of path length, and the degree of heterogeneity. And then there was some other issues like the bow tie. The bow tie was a very important structure. The bow tie is here, and this is, let me tell you the truth. We begin to work with this, and we found that from the mathematical point of view, and we don't know if this were relevant. And then I begin to read the literature review, and I found researchers like Lieber that say that every destination has to have this kind of pattern, of a structure. There are attractions that they are the gate, the gateway, the front door. Then you have attraction in the middle that they are highly connected, and then you have some doors where people go away. And we really found this using that. The another theory says that the attraction are clusters. It means that they are a point that is happen to be what we call the primary attraction. And then you have second the attraction around, and then you have third attraction. Third attraction are attractions that you don't even know that they exist, but you are going to discover because you go there. It's a kind of shadow theory. The primary attraction is giving the shadow and protecting all the others that I am around. That could be secondary or third. Then we could make also models about that. Then using the mobile data, we were able to build this kind of data where you have trajectories. Pseudo-identification with Hadamard hashes and an anomaly size, you have the idea which is the antique they pass through. Then using this data, we apply this model of network, and for instance for the unthins, because now the node are the unthins, we have an average path length of 44. It means that the average length of the path, it means the number of antennas that the path go through is 44, and the diameter is 10, and this is the unweighted path. It means that you don't count how many paths are passing for each node. And then you are lower in this way, and the diameter is 3. Well, surprisingly enough, here we have the bow tie structures. And as I tell you, first we found this bow tie, and then we asked, so what? And then we realized that a lot of literature were saying that destination should be like this, but we don't have enough data in order to prove, and we found it. Then here you have, this is the get inside, this is the modularity, everything is connected, and this is the go away, and these are disconnected. These are not in the system. Then we also found cluster. We found 14 cluster. It means a group of nodes or antenna that are more likely to be taking part of the same group. And I will show you then this is the antennas. I don't know if it is clear for you. The green point are the module. This is the module 1, which is one of the biggest. I have 123 antennas, and it's almost here in Gruyère that beacon, which I only have 31, which is, I can see here. Yes. Yes. Which is a very touristic place also. This is almost Freiburg, you see, the city of Freiburg. Now this is also Freiburg, but you see people that they are using the highway because we don't make difference between the lengths of trajectories. We don't split out. If the trajectory was 2 minutes or it was 3 days, we don't split out. We just use everything. And here there is another module, and I can show you we have found like this 14. Now the thing that we are doing, we are splitting down the trajectories between trajectories that last less than 1 hour. These are people that are crossing the canton just like this, then the one that stayed 2 or 3 hours, then the one that stayed 4 to 8. In the one that stayed 4 to 8, we split down the people that have spent an overnight or not, and then we have people that spend 24 hours. But if they spend 24 hours, they have to sleep. Then this is an overnight. Or more, and we are working on this kind of data, splitting down this data. And then I talk about trajectories. Then we could find the typical trajectories using this data, and I will go in to show them. Here are the trajectories. You see the red line? Yes, green. The green line. Here is one. Here is coming. You see this is one of the trajectories. What is interesting is the scope, the geographical scope. For the time being, of course, this is, you see here is another scope. The size of the location is bigger. These are the points that they visit together, but they don't mean that we know which are the path they use. Okay? It's the general aggregation path. Here you have another one. Of course, people don't fly over the sea, over the lake. And here is the one of Freiburg, which is very nice, because this proves that the model is working. This is our people that are going for a conference, from the hotel to the university, to the university to the hotel, and we have captured this. And if you see here, we are in another level, which is the cantonal level, and we found this is more or less people that are following the highway. Of course, this is a...
The blue points are antennas? There are some blue points?
No. This is the kind of antennas is here. But okay. They are not really the real antenna. There is an estimation of the position of them, because I cannot put really the antenna. Yes. Then I take all the ellipse and I make the mean of the latitude and longitude, because I'm not able to put the antenna. And here do you have it? Every time you have another level granularity of the space, of the territory. And there, I think that there is a golf over there. People are going around. Mm-hmm. And here you see we are in much higher level because we arrive at Neuchâtel. You see, this is almost people that go that are going around the highway, which is here. Here is another one. Then we have, at least gives an evidence that this trajectory exists. I don't say that they are the real one, but we prove that if you have enough detailed data and good mathematical stuff, you can find the trajectories. I think it is the last one, which is, you see here is the lack of Geneva, so-called lack of Geneva. This is the hotel Ibis at Bull, you see, and how people is going. So there, which is a company. This is another one. Yes, you see, and one more. This is the highway. That's why we try to spell down now, taking into account the whole period of each of trajectories, in order to put away the people that are just crossing by. Okay, well, I have a lot. This research sheds some light on the existence of strategic visitor flow. The graph algorithm seems to be the good tool. Personally, it takes a lot of time to find the good tools because in the first moment I tried to use data mining techniques. And really, I could not get through. It was really using graph and real mathematics that we do that. And then we are going to use, I will show you now the other, which is Be My Guest. I will talk a little bit to Be My Guest. Well, let me go to another presentation. Please, if you have questions, take advantage to ask now.
Just a random question.
Mm-hmm. A random question? Does that exist?
Is it easy to get data from SISCOM?
I beg your pardon?
Is it easy to get data from SISCOM?
No. It was just a sample, which is a research sample, and the date were shift, and they were anonymized, and so forth. It's quite difficult. Cool.
It's difficult to get any kind of data from central bank.
This is your world. I did not say it.
Off the record.
It depends on you. Okay, let me find where, no, it is in the other one. And then I have another one, yes, which is the presentation we make in Malta, and we get the first prize.
Good.
We make with my colleague, who is the director of Freiburg. Well, here is why having this strategic visitor flow is important. And this is only part of the story. Because Fischer-Meyer said with his students, he said that geographical distribution is one part of the story, but it's only one. There is another level, which is the beautiful one. In the same way that when you have trajectories, you have main attraction and the other that are under the umbrella, now tourists are not going like they are with the hand. Are not going there with the hand of their pockets, but they are using his mobile phone. And they just take care, like you just have to buy it. You go to the restaurant and you go to TripAdvisor and you see which are the restaurants around my position, and means that they are another level. One is the geographical level and the other is the virtual level. And the virtual level has to do a lot with experience, which is a kind of tarte à la crème. Everybody's talking about experience. That is really true. The virtual level, you have experience. And in the same way that you have geographically attraction, which are the star, in the virtual level, you have people that work in social network, which are the star. And their advice are followed. When you go to the restaurant and you see that one comment, it has been read by 1,000 of people, you think that probably it could be useful. Then there are different stars. And the whole challenge now in tourism study is just to spell out not only the strategical visitor flow from the geographical point of view, but the virtual visitor flow, which is so-called the travel network, which has at least two levels. Well, then Freiburg, how many overnight, and they have 10 different regions, 70 local tourism offices, 200 different overnight taxis, 200 different overnight taxis in only one canton in Switzerland. Switzerland is not big. Well, they just make a work and they put together, and the idea is just to find the visitor flows, and I will say just to find the network, how people are visiting Freiburg, because probably they go from one region to another and it is useless that you go together, because probably, I don't say just something that is not necessarily true, probably Ruyer has to go in India to make marketing with the Chateau de Chillon instead to go to Sarin to go to make marketing in China. Because you have to follow visitor flows. Then it's more effective to go where they go that go in the rational logic. And what they have do in Freiburg is just leave destination. They have made more stylized from the point of view, every point of view. They try to find immersion story. They use co-creation with tourists. They make focus group, asking them what would you like to make, which are the product that, or service that you have to do. Also, from the level of the organization of the DMO, they really simplify. There is the president and director, and then there are department. And each department, there is no hierarchy. Everybody is in charge of one or two or three projects, but everybody is responsible to the project. And then another thing that they want to do is the control of the flow. And have as much information in the real time. Then they just made this website. Well, this is another way that you can make, if you are making a master and you don't have data from the phones, you can use this kind of data of SiteMap, where you have the idea, the heat map where visitors go. This is used for taking into account the photo tag, the photo target. You see? And this would be my guess. This is the cover. This project It was born by one of the students in his bachelor thesis, and I was I have the honor to be the mentor of this student. He goes with this idea to the Union Figuratura del Turismo, they decided to really implement this. Then there is this kind of bracelet, which is made by plastic. It cost only 1.25 cents. It's made in Freiburg. You see the machine, and each bracelet has a number. Then when you go to the hotel will give you this bracelet and will activate it with this number. And given that, you have a lot of discount in several attractions. And more, you have in your mobile phone an app that you can download, where the people that suppliers can connect and say, well, I have not enough booking today for my restaurant. Then I make a pop-up and I say, today the dessert for kids is free, or I offer coffee, or whatever. You see, then it's a real time. In this way, they are able to follow the people. Here are the promotion. This is the people that the suppliers that they are participated and the promotion that they can do. And this is real time. Then this is the cartography. They know how many people are in each district at real time because they know how many people have processed. They have that for countries. Then they know which are the more frequent attractions, and then they can see like this how many people today are visiting, for instance, this museum. Yes, they can see the partner. It's so good that even the police is interested in this data. Well, then we have this data. Then now we have an idea. Our deal was to have an idea of that, which is the strategic visitor flow using this data. And we developed that for only 4 months. Now we have just till October. Our dream is just to doing that, just to know which are the selected attractions. We click there, we click in order to see the visitor flow, and then they figure out how to draw a story about that and make that people that goes over there. This is the idea. It means on the visitor flow, be able to build a virtual level. This is the very idea of that. For the time being, we are just analyzing the visitor flow. Well, this is the last part. I will show you. We have 73 attractions. We have more than 1,000 trajectories. The average length was very, very, very low. It was only two attractions, which is the hotel and once more. And that was so. And the number of places that visited. Well, I will not come back to these mathematical issues. This was the network, the real network, how it was connected. And you see, it's highly connected. And then we were happy because we found this bow tie. We found also the bow tie with this data that they are different of the other. And we have, this is the attraction that they had connected. This is the node that they are in, and this is the, and then we have two that they are disconnected. And then we make the graph about in. This is our in. This is the point where people go in. But of course, this is the high connected one. As you see, they are almost in Gruyere because the bracelet was very popular. They began to market that before in Gruyere. And this is the out points. And here are the two that they are disconnected. for the first month. Then we had also more group of attraction, which comes on the idea that there is an attraction and then secondary attraction around. We found them, even with this data that they are not very rich. We found four, and here is the first module. Here is the second, you see. Here is the third. And what is nice is, please, you have to have in mind that the only thing that we take in account in order to make this data are the group of attraction that they are together. But in none of the way we take in account the geolocalization. The geolocalization we use afterwards to see how they are. It means that this attraction, that they are in the German part of Freiburg, they are naturally. It's not that we put together because the geographic location has nothing to do with the analysis. The only thing that we use to just show the data and see, so what, if it's good or not. And this is the last module. Another thing that we have done is also the trajectories, to see which are the attraction that they are used. And we have found, I think that we have found some trajectories like this. You see, what is interesting here, I have the scale of 10 kilometers. This is one trajectory. Let's see then the second one, which is another scale. And this is natural, you see, as I tell you. This is, I am in the trajectory of 4 kilometers here, the scale.
Is this an average or an example of one person?
No, never one person. This is aggregated.
The aggregation.
Yes, it's the aggregation. Once you finish the graph, you calculate models, and then you can make the aggregation of more typical graph. But never one person, never. And this is the Ruyer. Somebody knows Ruyer. This is the city of Ruyer, where it's here in the Chateau of Ruyer. And you see here I am in the level of one attraction, I can say, because it's true that they are mutually. This is, I am in the level of 200 meters. And this is Freiburg, where we have very few data in Freiburg. And here is in the level of 400 meters. Well, then network analysis seems to be appropriated for this kind of analysis. We have shown that the theory of Lipper in the 90s, we can found that they are modularity, and they really, we can show that they are a tourism attraction system. We can show that they are in and out nodes, like some of our colleagues, distinguished colleagues, say. We have found different trajectory patterns with different geography scale, which is also useful. And this is a very important paper of Aureliana, talking about which is the generalized trajectory as we use. We take from there the definition. Well, but these are the things that they are pro. But we have things that we don't like. We think that the results are really dependent of the number of people that are adopted my guest. You have to understand that this was the first 4 months where this innovation came in. Then the results are not conclusive, and we don't have a lot of trajectory. Then it could be regional bias. For instance, that Gruyere is overrepresented. And then there is will be an overrepresentation of in on out node. Now we are working because I finished in last week to work on the raw data. We are making samples. We are making samples by districts. And we are going, we made 200 samples resampling by districts and what else? Yes, of kind, because now people that go to apartment have also the bracelet. Then we make a sampling from the district where the accommodation is, and also for the kind of accommodation, hotels, apartment, or self-catering, or others, because just for summer there was people camping. And we are developing 200 analyses on over these 200 sampling. Okay, then we are very happy to work with this kind of big data. We are going to find cross-validation between this and the sample that we have from our mobile, which is only the same that we use every time. And we like to have a way to make an automatization of the process in order that you can survey, let's say, every 15 days if you find new strategic flows. Of course, what I have to add, this is the strategic risk of the flows of primary, which is plan of chaos, you know. Okay, then this really challenged the organization of destination management, because, you know, more or less in Switzerland, the destination management are determined by the geographical position. You have a region and all the suppliers of the region, they put together in order to make marketing and so forth. This seems to be a very old way. Probably it's not the flow of power, but it's the power of flows that you have to take into account in order to do better, good job. It means that it's no longer top down, but bottom up, where the people goes, and in this way I make agreements and partnership. I think that's all, folks. Thank you. I can give you the paper. The paper I can give you to print it, because I cannot give you the PDF published yet by enter, but you can print it and then give to them. The paper with the antennas is already printed.
I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Is necessary that people who has the bracelet, the bracelet, download one app? Or no?
You are asking me if the application is successful or not.
Yes.
It's not really very, very successful. Mm. Not yet. Mm-hmm. Not yet. But they are working on that. But anyway, we are not following them by the application. Every time that they go to the to one museum, if they want to have lower, they have to give the bracelet, and the people will write the number, and they pay less.
Mm-hmm. Should you check when they access to the list?
Yes, exactly.
Finally.
Yes, finally. Yes, it's finally.
Not by the application.
No. The application is just to work. People are aware what they are doing. It's not that they it's voluntary, eh? Because they tell
you know
that. Yes.
When you're running, always the organization give you some chip.
No, there is no chip. It's not at all smart.
Okay.
Just a piece of plastic.
Okay.
It's just there is not a smart at all. It's just a piece of plastic. It's not smart. It's not. We could not have paid that. That's why everything has been done in Fribourg. The design. With the head of the cows, Flora, my friend Flora.
So maybe it would be much better to use only the application, not the bracelet.
Listen, much better could be possible, but it could be possible from the point of view of the protection of data. Because in Switzerland we are very keen about that. The protection of data is very strict.
Maybe it's a refuse from people to download it.
No, it's not for people, for the authority, the regulation of the confidentiality of data. Because everything that we have done, you have to ask the regulator of data if he agreed or not. And the thing that if you have the bracelet, people know what they are doing. If they give the number, they know that has been tracked. This is on the voluntary basis.
Yeah, but But if you explain well how the application works as well as the wrestling.
The problem is that it's not what you explain, it's what the authority would like you to do. And if the authority is telling you that you cannot go on, you cannot. Because you know you go to jail, you see. I was not in the story, excuse me, I come back. I was not in the story how they do that. I just have, but I know that they had the discussion with the authority. This was okay, but no more. And anyway, given that the people are not very keen to have a lot of application to the form.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I understand. I want to say that I understand his question because I know what's about the app. But yeah, the problem with the app is what you have said. Not much people is prone to install.
Yeah, but if you have a discount, at least.
Yeah, this is.
Well, there is an agreement and the cost of building the application is not the same as the cost of building and bracelet. It's two ways of doing things. Mm-hmm. For the time being, this is just working. We can play with the data because in the beginning we thought that it was not possible, but it seems that it's working. It's innovation. This is innovation. We are in the less than the 2.5 of voluntary tracking people in Switzerland. Then let's see how it goes and we change. But for the time being, we are quite happy. As I tell you, we have a lot of bias. The big hotel in Freiburg, one of the big hotels, I will not say who, he's not very happy because hotels try to lean the human resources. When you make a check-in, giving the bracelet, writing down the number, asking where they come from, and this created bias. That's why we work with sampling. We make 100. Yes, this is the way. Yes, if somebody's working in big data, if I can make an advice about big data, you have to work a lot with resampling every time. I think that it's difficult, but it's. I think it's a way to go. You resampling 200, 300 times, and you make the analysis, and you see how many times the analysis is the same.
But in your research in FIGO, did you keep the record of demographics, like the age of your...
Very few. We know where they come from, Switzerland or foreign, there are very few.
Because I think that when we're talking about application and this script, there are, in Switzerland, a lot of citizens, senior citizens, there are a lot actually, and they would not like to use apps or this kind of thing. Instead, they would prefer to go with the
bracelet. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
Sometimes it's depending on your target audience, whether they are maybe young people, they would love to use it, but. The other majority,
and so that
might have kids too.
Yes, it's not scientific, but when we make the first analysis of the data of Swisscom, the journalists come to make news on television, and they go and they make a micro trottoir. They go to the. Cable car, mm-hmm. And they ask people. Do you know that now you are being tracked?
Yeah.
And young people say, who cares? I am posting a photo of me anytime, at any moment in Facebook and so on. Then if it is good, it could help me to avoid the queue in a lot of time, why not? But we have to explain a little bit with the protector of data of the country. He said that then he see that everything was doing in the rules. It has to be done in an anonymized way and the aggregated way. This is the basic. If you don't do that, this you cannot go.
Do you have further analysis of
the
shared characteristics of these secondary attractions, which allow them to included in the same password.
This is what we are working now on. Yes, you see, that we are making resampling, because if not, we can have bias. Then if it is a star, it has to be a star. You say if you make 100 resampling, you have to have that 97% or 95%. At that moment, you can say this is kind of significant. This is the way we are trying to do.
And have you done the comparison between the different nationalities, how different of their travel patterns?
Not yet. Because of the data that we have for the time is only one country, and I cannot say which one because of confidentiality of the reason, and it's not Swiss, but I cannot say which one. Then we cannot yet do that. Using Be My Guest, probably we could go through, but using the mobile data, it could be different. The technique is there. The problem is the confidential of data, which is normal. I have no problem about that. So it could not go as quickly as we can. As a researcher, we are upset, but you have to accept this is the protection of everybody. What else? But as I tell you, when you have the strategic visit to flow, this is one idea. Then you have to have another idea. What would be nice is to know which are the behavior, the virtual behavior of people when they are in a destination.
That's important.
Yes.
That's important because that was my question, that whether your study addressed the issue of those tourists who come from different purposes, you know. If you're conceiving the routine or normal ancestor tourists, the pattern might be different. But if there is some kind of, you know, expo, exhibition, protest, and people get into that region, how do you manage that? Or whether your study addresses those people, or you just take them off the site, and you concentrate on normal entries?
We have asked some money. I don't know if we are going to have. Let's see how we have the idea to attack the problem with Professor Cantoni and one colleague of Argentina. For the beginning, we would like to know the role of weather in visitor flows, because you know how weather is. And we would like to have a way to track them, at least in Freiburg we have. Then you can see if it is awful day, probably people don't go with a cable car to see the wonderful landscape, but they go to the Museum of Tamili in Freiburg. And this is a way to do. And we are trying to do that. But have the geographical localization on the strategic flow is one part of the study. Then we have to find the way to analyze the higher level, which is the virtual one.
But then it will be a seasonal study?
Yes, of course. Yes, everything is seasonal. Yes, no, of course. Yes, should be seasonal. This is another thing that we have not done, yes. Because we have only 1 year. But
not much money.
Well, if you have data, we work Saturday and Sunday. This is not a problem. Because when in French we say quand on aime on compa. When you like, you really make. You don't save up your time. You have data, and you have to make them talk. You want to work anyway. Well. Questions? Comments?
Thank you so much for coming.
No more questions?
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Remember this afternoon, this evening, right? At 3:30, she will be here to have this face-to-face meetings with some of you, students, if it is anyone that would want to come.
Yes,
it's
also,
it's not British registered. It's,
and tomorrow I'm here also. So tomorrow I'm here.
Yeah, so tomorrow I'm here.
I will be able also. Uh-huh. Will be more than that. Thank you for that.
See you then at 3:30 here in this room.